Hey everybody, it's Becky, and these are my tips and encouragement for homeschoolers. The first thing I would suggest is to know the real reasons why you're homeschooling. Whether your kid was already in public school and you pulled them out for a certain reason, or you're going to plan on homeschooling from preschool on through their career at school, know the real reasons why you're doing it, because knowing those real reasons will help you along the way when you feel like quitting, and you'll think, no, no, I'm doing it because of this reason and this reason. So that's my first tip. Along those lines, I would suggest creating a homeschool mission statement. Pretty much every big company that's successful has a mission statement, and there's a reason for that, because it helps you set goals and priorities, and again, the reasons why you're doing things the way you are. And those will help you, you know, along the way. If you have those set goals and priorities written down, it'll help you when you're being pulled in a million different directions and you don't know what to do. If you can stop and look at the mission statement and say, okay, this is what's most important to us. Is this getting put into our everyday lives at homeschool? And that keeps you on track. And it's posted somewhere where you can see it every day. You know, if it's in your office or wherever you homeschool, put it where you can see it. My next suggestion is to have a support system. I mean, if you have family that supports you, that's great. But there's also other places you can find support. Facebook groups, YouTube channels, blogs, you know, pretty much every place you can find support. You just gotta seek it out. So don't be afraid to ask for that help. And the next thing I would suggest is to reevaluate the way you do things. You know, homeschooling is not a static process. Over time, you'll get experience, you'll find new curriculum, you'll find what's working for you and not working for you, what's working for your kids and what's not working for your kids. So, you know, don't be afraid to stop every couple weeks and ask your kids, you know, is this working for you? Or ask yourself, is this working for me the way I'm doing this? If not, then change it until it does work for you. That's just the main thing. Don't be stuck in a rut, especially with homeschooling, because your kids will get bored and you'll get frustrated and it will just cause stress for everybody. And then for us, a big deal was praying our way through the day, for me especially, because prayer is actually the very first step I took when I decided to homeschool my kids. It was a big decision, and my oldest daughter was already in public school, so it was a big decision to take her out. So prayer has really helped us, and it gets us through the day. And I'm not saying we don't have days that aren't stressful and overwhelming, because they are. But prayer definitely helps me to stay on track and stay focused and to remember why we're doing this in the first place. And then the last tip is just try to get organized in a way that works for you. I mean, I'm all about watching YouTube videos and Facebook, you know, groups that people post suggestions, and blogs where you can find suggestions and organizational tips and curriculum tips, and that's great. But make sure that whatever you decide to do, it works for you. Because if you can't find something you're looking for, or you don't know where to put things, and there's nowhere for things to have a home, then it's just going to add stress and time. It's just going to add stress to your day and suck the time out of your day, and you'll wonder where the day went because you're spending half the day looking for a certain paper or a workbook or something. So make sure you have an organizational system, again, that's not afraid to be changed, because everything changes. I mean, every time I organize something and I think it's perfect, I know in the back of my mind that it's probably going to have to change, because your needs change and the things you bring into your house change, and you know, you might start homeschooling two kids instead of just one. So have a system that works for you. But those are my tips. I hope those are helpful, and I'll see you soon. Bye.